Hey guys, welcome to WP Xbox, and today we have got Lumia 920 and HTC 8X with us. So we did it for 610 and 510, and now we're going to try it for 920 and 8X. So these phones are almost in the same range. So in this video, I'll help you to decide whether you're going to buy a 920 or whether you're going to buy 8X, depending on, you know, what kind of requirement or what kind of features both the phones carry on, because they're almost in the same price range. It's not a very costly phone, at least not in India. And this 8X is almost in the same range, both of them. So let's get to a feature by feature. I have it all listed with me. So we'll do a feature by feature, and I'll tell you, you know, what kind of thing you can do or which phone you need to pick up when it comes. So let's start with 920. The 920 comes with a richer display. It has a very good display. It's a high definition display as HTC 8X. There's a problem in the SD display, but the display of Lumia 920 is much superior because of the Pure Motion SD Plus. So if you're scrolling a lot here, nothing actually, you don't see a blur and all. And this phone is actually sunlight ready. So it means if you are taking this phone in sunlight and if you take out this phone in sunlight, you'll be able to read much more easily on Lumia 920 than HTC 8X. Second feature is high sensitivity. Now, in countries where you have snows and all, where you need to wear a pair of gloves and you cannot use your hands without using them, 920 comes with a high sensitivity, which means you can use a glove and still use your phone, which is not possible in HTC 8X, and it's possible here, or it's not possible in any other phone also. So that's the display part, a very nice display when you actually use it. And both of the glass has Gorilla Glass. It has the cornea and that has this curvy edge. The display has a curvy edge, which is actually very useful when you are swiping on left or right. So if you swipe left or right, you actually don't miss when it comes to this edges. So that's why these are curved, but it's there. It feels like it's a bit extended, but it's there. But if you take off HTC 8X, it doesn't have anything on the edges. Though edges are still extended, but the curvedness, like when you swipe like this, you know, you might miss when you are at the end, but with this 920 you absolutely don't. So that's the display part. Now let's take up the heaviness part. This is the most controversial part. Is Lumia 920 really heavy? I'll say yes for users who are switching from a phone which is like 510, a small phone. If you are moving from Samsung Galaxy Note 2, this phone is going to be a bit heavy and you won't feel it. But now if you compare both the phones, which is heavy, absolutely, 920 is heavier. In fact, after using HTC 8X for a while, when I moved back to 920, I felt it a bit heavy, but then I got used to it. So it's heavy for sure, but it's not like, you know, half a kilo of phone which you cannot handle. Now, there's advantage of 920 when you start using it. The edges are actually thinner. If you see the edges, these are pretty thin. So when you hold it, it comes out to have a very good grip, which Lumia 920 doesn't have. It's broad, so when you hold it, it actually feels bigger. So that's one more reason why Lumia 920 feels so big. But the grip here is pretty awesome. You give it to anybody and you ask him to hold it, this is going to be pretty good to hold it, and you'll feel, you know, I would love to have this phone. Lumia 920 turns out to be the heavy phone, but it's not a very heavy phone that's out to argue with, because, you know, and overall when you watch the video till the end, you will find out probably you can compensate for the heaviness with the features a bit. We'll get to know more about it. So one was the grip I talked about, so it's pretty easy to use. Now, let's take a look at the other parts. Now, HTC 8X has this button, the lock button on the top. Now, for a phone which is so long, it's not very wide because you have good grip, you can reach. But for a phone which is very long, and if you hold it like this, for example, I'm holding it like this, so my finger needs to come here to find the lock button. But if the lock button would have been here, I would have been able to do it very quickly, because when you take out the phone from your pocket, you don't actually look at it while taking it out. just take it out and try to unlock. And this is very difficult. It took me 2 weeks. I tried out for 2 weeks, but I still couldn't get the lock properly. Lumia 920. This has a major advantage, having all the buttons on the side. So when you take out your phone, you don't have to think. Just click and it unlocks. That's how you do it. It's very, very easy on Lumia 920. I love this part when I moved from HTC 8X to Lumia 920 back. So that's one part. Now, there's another drawback of 8X. The buttons. Now, this is a thin phone, though the thickness is not a lot. If you take a look at close look, the thickness is not a lot. Since it has a tapering end, it looks like it's thinner. Now, because the phone is very thin at the edges, the buttons have gone thinner too, which makes it very difficult for a lot of people, including me, to use this button or even to find this button. You know, I feel like I had pushed it, but I didn't push it. That's kind of feeling I get. Lock screen is it has another problem apart from being on the top. It's thin. I'm not able to push it properly. I mean, it's not like you can't push it. You can eventually push it. But the easiness which you get on Lumia 920, it's not there with 8X when it comes to buttons. So that's one part. So that's all the ease of use section. Now we'll move on to the how good the phones are when it comes to dirt, fingerprints. Both the phones has them. Not even Lumia 920 escapes it. It has a problem with catching up dust and fingerprints, so you need to clean your phone. And it has a glossy finish. It even catches more. So all fingerprints will be there, you need to clean it. But there's a bigger disadvantage when it comes to 920. And it's not, the 8X. Now this is not because it's 8X. It will happen because because it has a matte finish. It has a soft matte finish, not a proper matte finish. But it has a soft matte finish, which eventually captures fingerprints. And it even captures oils, any cream you have put on your hand and you hold your phone, the mark stays there. And if it's heavy, it's going to be a permanent mark. So that's one thing you need to be knowing about HTC 8X, that there's a problem with the matte finish. It will catch dust and marks like oil and anything else. If you're eating food and you just catch up your phone and you put a mark there, oil mark or food mark, it's going to be there. That's for sure. It's going to go away, but it can leave still a bit of mark. There's another problem which I didn't find out, but I've heard that the matte finish phones have this problem of areas like here getting ripped off, because if you put in your jeans and take it out a lot. So it's not that strong when it comes to build. I mean, especially the matte finish is doing something about this. But Lumia 920, for me, it worked well. It has a very strong body. Both are polycarbonate and both are like single body. There's no problem from that point of view, but it has a very strong build, especially the glasses. It has something for 2.5D glasses, which actually make them even more stronger. But again, it's not like it's very scratch proof or it cannot break. It can obviously break, but it's still resistant to scratches compared to 8X because of the kind of glass it has. So that's the glass part. And now we'll move on from our look and feel and ease of use and the high resolution and all those to battery life, which is the most important aspect of any mobile phone. Now, I've used both the phones on 2.5, the Edge, which is almost like 2.5G. It's not 3G, but it's 2.5G. So that's kind of network I have tested it on. And it worked out almost like for a day for me. That was like 24 hours. I have the screenshot ready. If you can check out the post, which is linked below in the video, you can actually go and see that snapshot. So it has, on an average use, it goes out for 1 day on a 2.5G network. And probably I will update a comment in the video or in the description when I test it out on 3G. I'm expecting this to go for like at least 10 to 12 hours on 3G, because these are like big phones, though, even though house packed with, you know, even bigger batteries. But on 3G it's going to be different, because that's a technical problem. So we'll tell you about the 3G part soon enough. But on 2.5G and all it goes for 24 hours. So you can actually find out, you know, how it will be lasting on a 3G network. So that's the battery life part. Now we'll move on next to the storage capacity. This has, 8X has a 16GB internal storage, no micro SD slot. Lumia 920 on the other hand has 32GB of storage, almost, it's like double of the space of HTC 8X, and it also doesn't have a micro SD slot. Now if this phone would have had a micro SD slot, I'd have preferred this phone on storage space. But since it doesn't, and Lumia 920 has 32GB of space, I will suggest you this phone if you are looking for a lot of storage space, but doesn't have micro SD slot. So that's one point you should remember. It has double the space. So that was the storage space part. Now we'll move on next to the camera part. Now we have done, one of our friends, CyberCool10, has done a detailed review of camera. But what here I will do is, I'll give you a quick talk about how camera and all is. Lumia 920 camera is super solid when compared to HTC 8X, both in low light and daylight. The video that the image that comes out from HTC 8X is a bit dull, and if it goes on low light, it's all grainy and all those stuff. But Lumia 920 has done a terrific job. Not only both of them have SD and all is okay, but this has an excellent mode. For example, HTC 8X camera doesn't autofocus when you move around. So if you are taking a picture like this, you know, if you're taking a picture and you move on your camera a bit, or it moved a bit, the focus doesn't shift automatically. It takes a bit of time. So the conversation that goes on between the 8i and the HTC 8X sensor is somewhere, it is missing, it doesn't autofix. But Lumia 920, if you take a photo with this, it will never lose the focus. It automatically shifts it so fast that you will see it happening. I won't say you won't realize it, but when you take a camera, when you take a, try to take a photo and move your, you know, camera like this, you will see the focus, how quickly it shifts. And even if you are doing it on a run and you're trying to take it quickly, this will never fail you. Low light. Now most of us take photograph on low light. I mean, you won't find ambient light like this, which in which I'm recording all the places. You go to a hotel, or you go to a restaurant, or you go to a poolside, it's always low light. The ambient light is not that good all the time. 920 has done a terrific job. This is one of the major plus point of 920, that can take very clear photographs on when it comes to low light. HTC 8X, obviously it failed. It failed terribly. We will have the images also along with this. So probably next will be the image of HTC 8X versus 920. On low light. Now 920 images were very vibrant when it came to daylight photograph, and this wasn't that vibrant, it was a bit dull. And micro mode was better. 920 was a lot better, but more or less it was equal. I wouldn't say it has a very good advantage when it comes to macro mode, but it was almost the same. But 920 has its advantage because of the good camera sensor and the AI which is built into the software that works very nicely. Then let's come to wide angle. Now this is the phone that has been advertised for wide angle, which means if you are standing very close to a group of friends, like 5 or 6 of friends, and you go and very close to them and you take a snap, you can actually fit all of them into one photograph, which 920 cannot do. 920 is not built for wide angle. It has a wide angle photo, wide angle camera, so the focal length and all, so it takes a good amount of people into one single photo. So that's one good advantage of 920. So that was the part of images, how you take photographs and all, and the advantage of 920 in that. Next we'll move on to taking a video with 920 and HTC 8X. Now if you have been already following our channel, we posted a video on which we took on the helicopter, we did with Nokia India. So you can understand how stable the 920 OIS technology is. It's optical image stabilization, which makes sure that if you move your camera a little bit, the camera moves a little bit up, so it compensates for your hand movement, which makes sure that the video that comes out is not a very shaky video. It don't feel like this, but it's going to be very stable. I have done, in fact, I did, if you watched the HTC 8X unboxing, I did it with 920. I've shot a lot of video with 920 single-handed, not even the two hands for most stabilization, but with single-handed, and you can actually see almost zero. I don't say it's perfect, but it's almost zero. So if you are going out with the family and you want to catch up a video and you want it to be very stable, this is the phone you want, both for image and video. This is a perfect companion. That's what the price you pay for. So that was the video part. Now we move on to the next section, which is, now HTC 8X has a Beats audio with HTC technology, which is actually very good to hear. So if you plug in your headphone here and you start listening to songs and all, HTC 8X gives a very pleasant experience. You feel like you're in a surround sound system and it all sounds nice. But Lumia 920, Nokia has done a terrific job here. It has brought in an equalizer in this phone. So let me just open it up for you, so you can just catch up with that. Right now it's not enabled, but I'll give you a look. So that's the equalizer. Let me give you a closer look. That's the equalizer, which has a lot of settings in that. And it has a Dolby support also. So, you know, you get to hear the Dolby voice and all inbuilt in the phone. So even though HTC 8X has a Beats audio, which is far superior than what 920 has, but the presence of an equalizer and Dolby on off and audio leveling and all makes 920 more wanted than 8X when it comes to audio. So if you want an equalizer, if you're a fan of equalizer and you've been missing it in Windows Phone, this is the phone you need. 920 has an equalizer in it. So that's a part. Now we'll move on to game performance. 920 and 8X both did a terrific job when it came to gaming. Even though I found a glitch here, but I'll ignore it because it happened just in one game. I played a lot of games in both the phones. It just happened in one game, so it's a game problem most probably. But both have a very high, it's like 720p on both the phones. So, you know, the games come out to be very nice and there's no problem or not. Except 920 has a bit of heating issue. That's what I've seen. After playing it like for 15 minutes, I see it getting a bit heated. It doesn't affect the phone performance or the game performance, but it does get heated. That's one drawback of 920, which doesn't happen in 8X, at least in a 15 minute range. I don't know if I played for an hour or so how heated it will be, but 920 had this one drawback here. So that was the green part. Now let's move on to the final section of this video. That's going to be exclusive apps. Nokia has always done a great job when it comes to exclusive apps. You can find Nokia City Lanes, Nokia Maps, Nokia Drive, and Nokia whatnot on this Lumia 920. They bring in a very hardware, you know, very strong hardware, but they also bring in a very strong software support. So even, you know, if Microsoft one day decide that they're not going to upgrade Windows Phone 8 from Windows Phone 8 to Windows Phone 9, Nokia still is making effort for 7.8, you know, the people who didn't get their upgrade from 7.5. So that kind of upgrade you can expect from Nokia. You can trust Nokia when it comes to software, not just on the hardware. They're going to support, they're going to bring an exclusive app, they have a ringtone app and all those to make your life much easier on Windows Phone 8. So if you want that, those kind of apps, you won't find in HTC. There's no exclusive app on HTC 8X, except one app which I found, which I actually demoed also on this channel, that is make more space. So that one makes sense, and I would have loved if Nokia would have got the same kind of stuff. But a HTC 8X has just one or two couple of apps. It doesn't have a lot of effort from software part. So that was the exclusive apps. So now time to wrap up actually. So like pricing, I'll tell you at the end the pricing. At least in India, HTC 8X is selling for 35.7K. And pricing of Lumia 920 officially is 38. But if you check out Flipkart, it's 37K. And if you check out Seholic, it's 36K. And I'm sure when it comes to retail, it even will go down. Because I had a couple of friends who have talked to the retailers and they say like, you know, this phone pricing might go down to 35K. So if it goes down to 35K or 33K, both the phones are in the same range. So there are a lot of advantage with Lumia 920, both when it comes to video quality apps, audio, and software, and the kind of upgrades and support it'll get. It's going to be terrific, especially the image, optical image stabilization. It's terrific to Lumia 920. HTC 8X is a great phone when it comes to, you know, like if you are a kind of person who have small hands, probably you should go for HTC 8X, because this has a very strong grip. Even for the girls and, you know, like some of the friends who, the female friends who have checked out HTC 8X, they say like this is a very good phone to hold on, a very excellent grip, and it has the Beats quality, so you won't be disappointed in the audio part, even though it doesn't have equalizer, but you won't be disappointed, that you can trust me on. And overall, the phone is an excellent quality. It has 720p, it can record in 1080p, and a good, if you compare, obviously it's not that great, but low light performance is not good. It takes a good video, there's no problem in that. Again, it's going to shake if you're going to take video with this, because Lumia 920 has obviously the OIS factor. So that's the kind of inputs I will give for Lumia 920 and HTC 8X. So now it's upon you to decide which phone to pick up. Both are in price range. I've told you the advantages and the disadvantages. So that's all, folks. Lumia 920 versus HTC 8X, and we'll come up with more videos like this. Do ask us a lot of questions for us, so we can answer you and help you suffice what your question is. Thanks for watching.